Welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. Today we are going to look into this really organic and beautiful form inspired by shark skin. Are you ready? Let's get started. I was doing my research and happened to find this beautiful texture from shark skin under the microscope. If you're interested, you can look into more of the picture there. So today I would like to show you my way to mimic this texture in the rhino. That's starting with the sphere and get a general form. We're gonna coming over here. And for whatever size that you are going to design. And I also like to make them a little bit thinner by 1D scale, so it's not like over puffy there. So let's get a general form first. We are going to rebuild this guy and get a lot more point there. Currently we have 8 and 5. You see we even it out, it's going to look like that. So I need a lot more point on that. We're going to create about 16 over there on the U and 8 on the V and click OK. Let me also bring in the picture that I found online and just a reference over here. We like to get the shape like this first one on the left here. So what I like to do is to turn on my control point and kind of pulling this guy up and maybe scale it down a little bit. At the same time, moving it down, scale it down with the gumbo. So we want to get a basic shape over there. I may want to bring this up a little bit and pull it out. So you kind of play with it and get the shape that you like. Maybe a little bit more pointed. All right. So another thing that we are looking at this picture also, the middle is kind of bumpy up. So I would like to do is select a point, any point right in the middle on the top. Instead of select all of them, I would like to do is coming into the selection and then you have this select point. You can target anywhere you like or just let it flow over there. And I like this one to be there so it's easier for me to use it every time. I don't have to kind of moving it around. So what I like to do is I like to select the V and you can see it select all the way on the top from the beginning and the end. And be really careful, you probably don't want to select that point. So we are going to deselect the point at the very end on both sides, otherwise you'll get something super pointed. And then we are going to using the gumbo to pull it up. So then you will get the shape like this. Notice that this is a little bit too sharp over there. I actually don't want them to be coming out exactly the same distance. So let me go back one more step. This time we wanted to use the command by comparison. Let's use move UV in. With this command, it's going to give you a box like this. And I'm just going to tuck it somewhere here. So this is actually very good control point editing option that you have here. You can move with the U, as you can see this is the way they move it, or you can move it with the V. But I like to do is moving both U and V at the same time, so I like to move it like that. So notice that the way you move is more smoothly, so you don't get that big bump over there. And if you, so let me go back one more step and I like to move it a little bit more. You can kind of move it a little bit and keep dragging and keep dragging until you are satisfied with the shape. Now you can also with this one, let me move it back a little bit. So to find something, it is smoother. If you want this one coming up more, you can have this going up like this. Okay, so now we have this one. Let's look at the picture one more time. The picture right here is showing it. This is kind of going in this way. It doesn't follow the way that we have going this way on the shape. So if I wanted to select another row, for example, turn on a control point and select this one and use what we had, selecting with the V and try to pull it up. Notice that it is going into this direction, but it's actually straight down. So it's hard for us to do the control point at this point is because it is, the control point is following the surface. So we need to have this bump coming up, right? So the way that I will suggest to do is using the cage edit. With the cage edit, I'm going to select this one and choosing the bounding box aligned to the wall. I like to have X has a lot more point for 16 and Y for the 8. Z we can stay for 4. So we'll get a box like this. Now coming into the top view, I'm going to pick up a straight line going roughly maybe like here and also here at the same time for both right and the left. And I do not want to change anything at the back, so I'm deselecting the bottom two. So this is what I select. I'm simply just going to use the gumball to pull it up. Okay, so you can see that we get this as a straight line pull up instead of a follow the curvature that we have over there. So now we have this one. If they are too bumpy, you can also want the scale down a little bit to fit whatever shape that you have over there. And you can kind of tweak it until that you find the final shape that you like. One more thing I like to do is I want to turn on the control point and notice that this is some sort of a rim-ish things there. So what I like to do is I want to pick up maybe 5 or 6 from the right and or maybe 5 or 6 point to the left. All right. And again, I want to use selection for selecting V over here. So that will select the entire age around with all the point. And again, let's play with UVN to make them coming out a little bit. So then you will have a rim, and let's take a look on this render view. Okay, so you can keep tweaking and playing and get the shape that close to whatever you want. And since this is a demo, so I'm going to stop here and for you to play with it. The second thing we wanted to do is I want to creating a surface. The surface is going to be like this and for whatever size that is. And then I'm going to rebuild the surface. That's rebuild into U for 4, V for 4. And then we got something like this. Let's turn on the control point. And basically I want those points go down. Those two on the edge go up. This two going down and this two going up. So now we will have a very interesting curved surface instead of flat one. All right, so I'm going to arrange the pattern on it. So the way that we are going to do is we're going to create a UV curve for this one. So this is the area if this surface flattened out, and that's area going to be. So I'm going to make this guy a little bit smaller because it's going to be the pattern, and I'm going to arrange over here. Let's take a look on the top view. Okay, so to make a multiple, I'm going to use a linear array to array this guy maybe 10, holding my shift, coming over here. Okay, once I have that, I'm going to making a copy, just dragging my gumball and to overlapping somewhere about this one, and tap your alt key so you can make a copy. I'm going to make another copy, just drag it up, hit the alt key, and another copy, drag it up, hit the alt key. All right, so this is the pattern I'm going to flow. I mean, you can do different kind of arrangement if you want to. So we need to flow this pattern back to the surface. I would like to do is to use this curve and use the command surface from planar curve. All right, and make sure that this is where the how high you want it to be, the position that you want it to be. double make sure, let's take a look on the render view and see if that is the pattern that we want. Okay, so it looked nice over there. We're going to flow it back by flow along surface. And we're gonna pick up all the object over here. And we're gonna pick up one of the corner on the bottom right here. And then the target will be the same corner right there. So let's take a look at if it flowed nicely and look like it's in the right position. Let's take a look on the render view. All right, so this is the way we creating the texture mimic the shark skin under the microscope. More video that is member only on my membership program. If you are interested, please join our membership and I'll show you more of my trick and tip to do all kind of a 3D model with the Rhino 3D. I hope you enjoy this video. Please like and comment and let me know how you like it. Thank you and I'll see you next.